don't know if you guys noticed last week on Twitter, somebody put a picture of me and Leah, and they said that they had moved on from the church and, you know, started listening to the joint again, but that they were proud of me and Lee, that look at the changes that we had made, you know, that I looked a lot better, you know, he looked a lot better, we both sounded happier, we both made changes that nobody knew would happen. Listen, it was very hard for me to tell Lee that I wanted to stop doing the podcast. It really bothered the fuck out of me for a long time. I never spoke about it, but I thought it was time for Lee to move on. I had this kid working for me for 8 years. I could see that I wasn't happy. I didn't know at the time, because listen, man, you never know you're living in hell. You never know. That's the name of these two episodes. You don't know you're in hell until you live it. You know, I've been in hell three fucking times. When before I went to prison, that addiction I had, the hell I had in my first marriage, and the fucking hell I had the last 4 years of living in LA. I didn't know it was affecting me as much as it did. But once I landed here, I noticed that, you know, how unnormal I was and how unnormal I felt. I felt like when I first got out of jail, you know, like you feel like you don't fucking belong. But today, Monday the 5th, I feel a lot fucking better. You know, it's fight week. We got a great fucking week. It's a short week. A lot of years are off today. My daughter starts camp fucking Tuesday finally till 3 o'clock. I got a fucking life again. You know, last week was CCD camp, so she was home at 12. So from fucking 12 to 6, I'm Johnny Entertainer. I'm fucking sore. I had to swim. I threw softballs. I got hit in the ear with a fucking softball. I don't, you know, it's the life of a dad, and I'm enjoying it, and I'm not complaining about it, and it was great. But today we have a guest. I know it's Monday, and you're like, Joey, it's hybrid. We want you. Fuck it. We got a guest. And the guest's name is a two-part interview. It's today and Wednesday, so knock yourself out. We're going to cover all the things you wanted to talk about. Our guest today is the world-famous, the man from outer space, Mr. Lee Syatt. I hope you enjoy this, and I'll talk to you afterwards. Stay black. What's up, cocksucker?
How's it going, buddy?
It's going great, man. Woke up fucking great. Slept late today.
Oh, yeah?
Got up at 4 in the morning. I told you, Lee, how fucked up did I sound the other night on 325 milligrams?
I thought you weren't telling anybody about that. Yeah, you sounded, it's always, you get real quiet, you start whispering, like, oh, man, I'm fucked up. But then you start giggling. That's funny.
Listen, man, it's just tremendous to drop your tolerance.
Oh, like, yeah.
I remember eating four of those fucking things and nothing happened. Four 100s or four 200s and nothing would happen.
And you were putting that, what, that like wax needle thing into
needle
your T2?
That was 987. I did that like four times and I'm like, I'm going to fucking die.
I thought you were doing that every night. And then the tea was medicated too, wasn't it?
The tea's medicated. I didn't drink that last night. I gave that a breather last night. I just took three capsules. I drank a little bit of fucking melatonin from Onnit, and I did my three capsules from magnesium, and I got up at 4:11 to pee, and fucking next thing you know, I'm like, holy shit, I'm fucking stoned.
Wow. I never understood that, man, because we would do those things, and I would be high most of the next day. And you would wake up at 6, be like, I'm at the gym already. I'm doing, like, it didn't affect you. I had no idea how you wouldn't. I would wake up still high all the time. And I had no idea how you didn't wake up high.
Well, you know, when I wake up high, when I make a mistake on my fucking tweet, like I write something wrong. You don't know how many times I've tweeted and I go back to look and I'm like, I forgot tweeting that. Like,
really?
I wake up. Sometimes I wake up so fucking stoned, like not lately, but when we were doing the podcast, I wouldn't know what the fuck I wrote on there till lunchtime. I'm like, what the, why are people going crazy? Oh, you wrote about, you know, Obama's wife, pussy or something. I don't fucking know. That's how high I was getting. I would just giggle and shit like that and fucking tweet. Lately, what I do here is I get up, I get a cup of coffee, and instead of going right to my desk, I go outside.
Okay, so you wake up a little bit?
I look at the trees, I breathe, I look at the woodpecker. You know, some fucking woodpeckers out there, like I'm dying to fucking shoot him with a bow and arrow. But
I'm surprised you haven't yet.
You know what? It's nature. What am I going to do? I can't kill everything. There's chipmunks.
Leave a little edible for him. See what happens to the squirrels.
That's not a bad idea. Give one of those motherfuckers 100. Their heart will blow up. But then every time a dead animal's around here, I got like fucking hawks all around. I told you, the Chinese lady across the street, great people. Great people. They got a French poodle.
Okay.
And one night, the girl came out with a French poodle. She had the hot pants on. I'm on the balcony with the fucking rocking chair, you know, just watching her. And all of a sudden, she looks on the roof, and there's three of those fucking buzzard birds that just eat dead shit.
Right.
They were all over. They were, like, on her roof making noise. And they were on the trees across the street. And she kept looking at the trees. And she kept looking at the fucking, at the house. And then she looked at me, and I'm like, you better run. Because those birds will pick that fucking French poodle up and bring him back to Taiwan, wherever the fuck he's from. Dog, that bitch ran in, brought the dog in, and then she came out with a mother and father, and they were looking at eagles. Then they crossed the street, and they asked me what they were. And I go, they're buzzard. Whatever. They just eat fucking dead birds and dead elk. You know, you see fucking dead elk here.
Oh, yeah. Have you hit one yet? Have you hit a deer yet?
No, thank God. I saw one the other day up close and personal with his 3D eyes right next to me in the fucking light. He was right there. I'm like, what the fuck are you doing here? Were you waiting for a light? Go.
Jesus.
My daughter's like, Daddy, he's right there. No. There's a street that they always pop out on, and I'm real, you know, I do 10 miles an hour, and, you know, I take my time, but there's every fucking animal here.
Like, are there turkeys? There's turkeys by where I live in there.
There's turkeys.
Fucking, they're disgusting. I hate
them. On the way to Colts Neck, you see people with fucking gigantic turkeys. Last night, I saw two goats.
What?
Yeah, the guy just let his goats out in front of the fucking house. I went to eat Japanese food with some families Friday night, and on the way back, me and my daughter like, what the fuck are those? Who would leave their dogs out this close to fucking a road that's like heavy duty? And when I got up close and personal, it was two billy goats just eating their fucking stuff. Jesus and I told my Christ. Wife, and she's like, I know there's a guy around the house that's got chickens. I find out this motherfucker got chickens. That's easy pickings for me.
Oh, yeah.
That means I'll sacrifice one a week. I'll take a buzzard and fucking sacrifice him. Next thing you know, I'm betting the Yankees. I don't give a fuck, Jack.
Save one for me. That's what Jews do. Has they already told you about that?
Yeah, I've seen it.
I think it's Yom Kippur.